देखो, द टॉपिक इज योर वेक्टर स्पेस। अर्लियर यू हैव स्टडीड अबाउट ग्रुप्स एंड फील्ड्स। नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट वेक्टर स्पेस, और समटाइम्स इट इज रिटन एज लीनियर स्पेस। बिफोर गिविंग द डेफिनेशन ऑफ वेक्टर स्पेस, वी शैल मेक अ डिस्टिंक्शन बिटवीन इंटरनल एंड एक्सटर्नल कंपोजिशन। लेट अस सी। सपोज ए बी एनी सेट। If A star B belongs to A for all A, B in A, and A star B is unique, then star is said to be an internal composition in the set A. Here A and B both are belonging to A. There, that is why this star is called as internal composition. But if V and F be any two sets, and if A O alpha belongs to V for all A in F and for all alpha in V, and A O alpha is unique, then this operation or this composition O is said to be an external composition in V over F. Since here A and alpha both are different from different sets. A is from the field F and alpha is from the set V. That is why this composition A O alpha is called as external composition. Now, let us see the definition of the vector space. Let F plus dot be a field. We have a field F plus dot. Plus dot means F is equipped with two binary composition, plus and dot. The elements of F will be called scalars. Let V be a non-empty sets, and whose elements will be called as vectors. Then this V is a vector space over the field F if first there is defined an internal composition in V called addition of vectors and denoted by plus. It means for this composition, V is an abelian group. We will see it later on. Next. Alpha plus beta belongs to V. For all alpha beta in V, alpha plus beta is equal to beta plus alpha for all alpha beta in V. Alpha plus beta plus gamma in a bracket is equal to alpha plus beta plus gamma for all alpha beta gamma in V. There exists an element zero in V such that alpha plus zero is equal to alpha for all alpha in V. We call this element zero as zero vector. To every vector alpha in V, there exists a vector minus alpha in V such that alpha plus minus alpha is equal to zero. Now, second, due to these five postulates, V plus is an abelian group. Second, there is an external composition in V over F called scalar multiplication and denoted multiplicatively. That is, A into alpha belongs to V for all A in F and for all alpha in V. In other words, V is closed with respect to scalar multiplication. Now the third one, the two compositions, that is scalar multiplication and addition of vectors, satisfy the two other postulates. What are these? First, four other postulates. First, A into alpha plus beta is equal to A alpha plus A beta for all A in F and for all alpha beta in V. Second, A plus B into alpha is equal to A alpha plus B alpha for all A, B in F and for all alpha in V. Third, AB into alpha is equal to A into B alpha for all AB in F and for all alpha in V. And fourth, 1 into alpha is equal to alpha for all alpha in V, and 1 is the unity element of the field F. So for proving a non-empty set V to be a vector space, we need to prove all these three conditions, 1, 2, and 3. 1 is V plus is abelian. 2 is for scalar multiplication, or you can say external composition, and 3 is for scalar multiplication and addition of vectors. When V is a vector space over the field F, we show that VF is a vector space, or sometimes we write only V is a vector space if it is clear that what is the field. If F is the field R of real numbers, then V will be a real vector space. And if F is Q, then V will be a complex vector space. And if F is C, we will, we no no. If F is Q, V is a rational vector space, and if F is C, V is a complex vector space. Addition of vectors by the symbol F plus, it is denoted by the symbol plus. There should be no confusion about the two compositions. Alpha plus beta represents addition of vectors in V, and A plus B represents addition of elements or scalars of F. That is, if AB belongs to F, then A into B represents multiplication of two elements of F, where A belongs to F and B belongs to F. And if A belongs to F and alpha belongs to V, then A into alpha will represent a scalar multiplication A into alpha, which is belonging to F, V, which is belonging to V. Since 1 belongs to F and alpha belongs to V, therefore 1 into alpha, it will be a scalar multiplication. Again, A alpha belongs to V and A beta belongs to V, then A alpha plus beta will belongs to V. Further, A belongs to F and alpha plus beta belongs to V. Therefore, A into alpha plus beta represents scalar multiplication, and A into alpha plus beta belongs to V. Note, C note, V plus is an abelian group. Therefore, all the postulates possibilities are true. First, see here, AB alpha is A into B alpha for all AB in F and for all alpha in K. Second, 1 into alpha is alpha for alpha in K, and 1 is unity element of the field F. 1 is also unity element of the field K, therefore 1 into alpha is for alpha in K. These are not necessary. See this note. If C is the field of complex numbers and R is the field of real numbers, then C is a vector space over R, because R is a subfield of C. It is clear that the set of real numbers is a subset of set of complex numbers. But R is not a vector space over C. Here, R is not closed with respect to scalar multiplication. For example, if 2 belongs to R and 3 plus 4i belongs to C, then 2 into 3 plus 4i, it is not a real number, it is a complex number. So R is not a vector space over C. There is a very good example. See, the set V of all M by N matrices with their elements as real numbers is a vector space over the field F of real numbers with respect to addition of matrices as addition of vectors, and is multiplication of a matrix by the scalar as scalar multiplication. So this question has been asked several times. So see its solution. You can easily prove that V is an abelian group with respect to addition of matrices. The null matrix O of the type M by N containing all the elements 0 will be an additive identity of this element abelian group. If A belongs to F and alpha belongs to V, then A into alpha will be in V, because A into alpha is also a matrix. C alpha is a matrix M by N type, and A is a scalar. So A into alpha, it will also be a matrix of M by N type. And its elements will be real numbers, because all the elements of alpha will be multiplied by a real number. Therefore, V is closed with respect to scalar multiplication. Also, we know that first A into alpha plus beta is equal to alpha plus B, A beta. Since alpha plus beta, alpha and beta are two matrices, therefore alpha plus beta will be a matrix M by N type into A. It can be written as A into alpha plus A into beta, since A is multiplied by each and every element of the matrix alpha, which is of M by N type. Similarly, A is multiplied by A is multiplying each and every element of the matrix beta of the type M by N type. Second, A plus B alpha is equal to alpha plus B beta, sub plus B alpha, it is clear. And A to B alpha is equal to A, B alpha for all A, B in F, for alpha in V. 1 alpha is equal to alpha for alpha in V. 1 is unity element of the field F of real number. Hence, VF is a vector space. So, not a very big difficulty here. You can solve it very easily. Here, simple note. If V is the set of all M by N matrices with their elements as rational numbers, and F is the field of real numbers, then V will not be closed with respect to scalar multiplication. For example, root 7 belongs to F, and if alpha belongs to V, then root 7 and alpha is not in V, because elements of the matrix root 7 alpha will not be rational numbers. Therefore, VF will not be a vector space. Due to this, root 7 due to this root 7 alpha is not in B. Next, another example you can see. The vector space of all ordered n tuples over a field F. It is also a simple example. See, it's some part of its proof. Let F be a field, an ordered set alpha. How an ordered set is represented? See here. An ordered set alpha is represented by A1, A2, A3, so on, An of n elements of F. It's called an n tuple over F. Let V be the totality of all ordered n tuples over F. That is, let V is containing all the elements, all ordered n tuples, A1, A2, so on, An, such that A1, A2, so on, An belongs to F. This is our vector space. Now we shall give a vector space structure to V over the field F. For this, we define equality of two n tuples, addition of two n tuples, and multiplication of an n tuple by a scalar. First, equality of two n tuples. Suppose A1, A2, so on, An is equal to B1, B2, B1, so on, Bn. Then Ai equal to Bi for each I means A1 equal to B1, A2 is equal to B2, and so on, An is equal to Bn. These two elements, alpha and beta, will be equal, and they are belonging to set V. Next, addition composition. Suppose we have two elements alpha and beta, then alpha plus beta will be A1, A2, so on, An plus B1, B2, so on, Bn. It is equal to A1 plus Bn, A2 plus B2, and so on, An plus Bn for all alpha and beta in V. Because A1 plus B1, A2, B2, and so on, An plus Bn, they are all elements of F. Next, scalar multiplication composition. Define A into alpha as A into A1, A into A2, so on, A into An for all A in F, and alpha is equal to A1 into so on, An, A, V. Since A, A1, A2, so on, An belongs to F, therefore A alpha will also be in V. So V is closed with respect to scalar multiplication. Now we see that V is a vector space for these two compositions. First, associativity of addition in V. It is very easy. A1, A2, so on, An plus B1, A2, so on, An plus C1, A2, so on, An. Add these two elements. So it will be A1, A2, so on, An plus B1 plus C1, B1, 2 plus C2, and so on, plus Bn, Bn plus Cn. Then A1 plus B1 plus C1, A2 plus B2 plus C2, and so on, An plus Bn plus Cn. Or A1 plus B1 plus C1, A2 plus B2 plus C2, and so on, An plus Bn plus Cn. It can be written as A1, A2, so on, An plus B1, B2, so on, Bn, within a bracket, plus C1, C2, so on, Cn. So it is associative of addition. Then commutativity of addition is also simple. A1 into so on an plus B1 into so on Bn is equal to B1 B2 so on Bn plus A1 into so on an. Existence of additive identity, 0, 0 is an additive identity, 0 vector. So 0, 0, 0, 0, 0 is belonging to V. There are total n zeros. So it is additive identity. Similarly, additive inverse for each element alpha equal to A1 into so on an in V. We have minus A1 minus A2 so on minus n V. So V is consisting of additive inverse of each element of V. Okay, so this is all about this one. If you have any difficulty, you can ask me any question here. First note down, and after this, you can also call me at my given number.